there as well.
I know. Oh, yeah. There's seven within just, I'll skip the job.
Bang, call three in order. First item, roll call.
Alderman Arnold.
Here.
Alderman Salazar. Alderman Tillman.
Here.
Alderman West.
Here.
Alderman Austin.
Here.
Alderman Key.
Here.
Okay, next item is invocation led by Pastor Ray Green from Cross Creek Baptist Mission, followed by Flood Lewis from Alderman West.
Our Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for the gorgeous day you've given to us today. We thank you for Green Valley, a place so nice to live in. We see a lot of activities going on, and I just feel great when I come through town. And Father, I ask you for our children, you can watch over them and keep them safe. We thank you for our teachers and law enforcement who watch over them as well as us. And God, may you keep them safe. And those who respond when we have accidents and heart attacks and all kinds of medical issues, I pray that they'll not get discouraged, but they will be encouraged and continue on. Lord, we ask you to bless our country and its leadership. And I pray for our military, that you'll watch over each one of them. God, keep them safe. Now, be with these folks tonight who have decisions to make. I pray for them that each one have wisdom and that they will look out for whatever is best for the people of Green Valley. We thank you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you, Mr. President.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay, next item, the approval of the agenda.
No change, Mayor.
Okay. Seeing no proclamations, and move on to citizens' participation. We ask citizens who wish to address the board, come forward to the microphone and podium. Please give your name and address to the record.
James Fletcher, 513 Southwest, Lakeview Drive, Green Valley, Missouri. First off, I just want to say thank you to the city for allowing us to be downstairs for as long as we have been. We are moving to a new location here at the moment, so we will be moving to Southwest. But again, I wanted to say thank you for allowing us to be here tonight. Very much appreciate the city and everything for us and also just wanted to throw something out there about the CY garage sales last weekend, the Chamber of Commerce part of the front right over to Hawaii, and then no one else was very much to produce a successful event. We had a really nice professional map that was going out for all of the community to work and a lot of folks really Jeff City, Parks and Folks from the Oklahoma, down to Stoneville, Parks and Folks, came up with that. So, very much for sure. Thank you again.
Thank you. Anyone else wish to address the board? Seeing none, move on to the consent agenda.
Mayor, I'm going to have you set the consent agenda.
I have a motion on the bus to approve the consent agenda. Do I have a second? Second on Arnold. Any discussion? Seeing none, all in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, same sign. Seeing no previous business or new business, move on to presentation. We have the 2015 audit report, Trout, Demon, and Company.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor and members of the board. I'm Mike Rocha with Trout, Newman & Company, and we currently serve as your external auditors. And we have completed the audit for the year ended 12/31/15. I describe it as a solid year. You had some increases in your tax revenue, you had some increases in your water fees, you paid financial note at the end of the year. And in the accounting world, you implement a GASB 68 for the pension liability. So that was kind of a good thing for us this year. All that involved that for a lot of our tax. I'm pleased to report, though, that this city, City of Green Valley, has a pension asset that is pension liability. Not saying you can't go to the bank and withdraw that pension asset, but nonetheless, you're not underfunded by hundreds of thousands of millions of dollars you hear about from the government entities. So, Loggers appears that most of the city is working with that pension asset, so Loggers appears to be a fairly solid plan. So, that's good. Again, it was a solid year. There really wasn't anything dramatic or any particular difficulties. I'll just go through these financial statements pretty quickly. If you want to talk about them, feel free to stop me. Pages 5 through numeral 14 is the management discussion analysis that you've seen over the years. And this is a financial description of some of the activities that happened earlier, some of the variances and the changes. So it is a well-written document, so sometimes I encourage you to go ahead and read it. It is very informative. Pages 1 through 3 is your independent auditor report, and it is a qualified opinion, although it's only takes 3 pages to say that. Pages 4 is the statement of net position of the city as a whole. And you'll see about 8 lines down the net pension asset between the governmental funds and the business type funds and a $636,000 asset. So, again, you can't go to the bank and withdraw that. It just means that your pension contributions and earnings on those assets compared to your liability, you have more assets right now. Page 5 is the statement of activities for the company as a whole. Page 67 is the balance sheet, the governmental balance sheet of governmental funds that are the major funds in the city. The city has 5 major funds that have certain criteria of particular importance, and that's why it's displayed at the front of the document. Pages 10 and 11 is the statement of changes, revenue expenditures in the governmental funds. Pages 13 is the statement of net position of proprietary funds. And 14 is the operating statement of the proprietary funds.
The proprietary fund revenues were up
to 5.3 versus 4.9 last year, but that's more of a factor of the waste and gallons sold. Last year was a wet year, so most water utilities sold less gallons. But nonetheless, we had a increase. 15th cash flow statement for proprietary fund shows generating some nice cash from operating activities, which is 5 lines down, 1.57. $400,000. After that, we have the notes. Page 29, deposits and investments, does show the cash. Most of our cash is in bank deposits. We do have some certificates of deposit and some money market accounts. About 10.7 million in cash at the end of the year. Well, so all the funds combined. Page 30 and 31 show the capital assets activities. We had about 700,000 of capital asset additions to governmental funds and about 700,000 in the proprietary as well. Thank you. page 36, the changes in the long-term debt. The majority of the activity is paying off our existing debt service. We did refinance the mid-limits to extend it another year, which might be coming up for pretty soon. That's why you got a $3 million additional $3 million retirement. Some slight notes payable for the purchase of some land and some capital. Page 43 breaks down the tax revenues. You know, you can see your property taxes, sales taxes, parks taxes, transportation sales taxes, etc. General fund was up about, looks like about 50,000 from last year. Special revenue funds are up about a little over 100,000, and the debt service fund was up about 50,000. So again, slight increase in the taxes, tax revenues. Note 10 on page 44, that's the assessed valuation. Page 49, note 18, segment information. You have a combined water and sewer fund, so the segment information tries to break out there are some estimates in here, but tries to break out the operations between the water and the sewer fund. Then note 22 on page 50, we did have a prior period adjustment to put on the net pension asset. That was all kinds of fun. They put out their reports at 6:30, then you had to update it for the city's payments and the benefits and come back to your reporting rate. And so it was a fair amount of work to get that on the books, but from here on out it will be a little easier because it will be adjusting that liability or in the case an asset tax relation. After that, the supplementary information, page 54, is the general fund budget versus actual. Revenues were up about 44,000 from budgets and expenses were up 222,000 from budgets. Next couple pages are the other major funds. And after that, you have the combining statements and the budget statements for the other regions. Again, it was a solid year. We turned over this finance department personnel. That did cause a little bit of more work and some more entries and just access. It was a solid year, nothing dramatic or striking to me that it sticks out. Solid year.
Anyone runs across these, definitely read through them more. Get in contact with them.
Yeah, they should. All right. You're going to use your 6:30 deadline of having a statement, so.
All right. Thank you.
We appreciate the relationship.
Okay, next up on the agenda, the ordinances.
Mayor, this is the second reading of Bill B16-10. It will be ordinance 2388. It is an ordinance providing for submission of a proposal to discontinue application and collection of a local sales use tax on the titling of motor vehicles, trailers, boats, and outdoor motors, outboard motors that were purchased from a source other than a licensed Missouri dealer to the qualified voters of the city of Grey Valley for their consideration at a special election. We held concurrently with the primary election called and to be held in the city on August 2, 2016, proposing the form of the ballot to be employed at said election and directing the city clerk to do all things called for by law in connection with the holding of said election. Second, ordinance 2388.
Mayor, I move that we accept bill number 2016-10 with second reading, making ordinance number 2388.
I have a motion of Alderman Stanton to approve bill 2016-10 for its second reading, making ordinance 2388. Do I have a second?
Second.
Second Alderman Johnson. Any discussion?
Mayor and board, I think probably was covered in a previous email, but if you remember during the first reading, we weren't sure how this was going to go with government and taking action on this, but Ryan spoke to nearby cities, and the plan is still to go forward and put this on the ballot, even though we took action.
I think only
one of the
city actions. Questions or discussion? Seeing none, all fair, please say aye.
Aye.
All fair, same sign.
Henley?
Yes.
Hallcheck?
Yes.
West?
Yes.
Stanley?
Yes.
Johnson?
Yes.
Arnold?
Yes.
6-0, Mayor. We have three resolutions tonight. Two of them involve the park board. We have together the resolutions are 16-30 and 16-31, respectively. The resolution of the Board of Aldermen, City of Grand Valley, Missouri, reappointing Mark Combs and John Savala to the Grand Valley Park Board for 3-year terms each. Resolutions are 16-30 and 31.
May I move that we accept resolutions R16-30 and R16-31 as read?
I have a motion of Alderman Palachuk to approve resolutions R16-30 and R16-31. Do I have a second?
Second.
Second Alderman Dudley. Any discussion? Seeing none, all fair, please say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, same sign.
6-0 each, Mayor. Resolution R16-32 is a resolution of the Board of Aldermen, City of Grand Valley, Missouri, authorizing the mayor to enter into a real estate lease agreement with Star Acquisitions, Inc. Resolution R16-32.
Mayor, I move that we accept resolution R16-32 as read.
I have a motion of Alderman West to approve resolution R16-32. Do I have a second?
Second.
Second Alderman Stanley. Any discussion?
Yeah, I don't understand what the purpose of this is. What is that leasing the land for? I mean, I know the fee is nominal and that's what it is.
It's actually part of the tax program. To do that, there has to be a certain part that's designated as public parking. The fee back and forth is nominal, but it's kind of an administrative function that says a certain part is public parking. And it has to do with the tax, the mid side of it. So basically, if you remember on the original plat, the track that was in the middle, it was just a track and not a lot, and that was for public parking. So, in essence, you can't put a building on there, but it all has to do with meeting the requirements of the public good. So basically, this is just changing names for going to move.
So that's the current developer for the parking club. Because Price Chopper didn't want part of their lot because of public parking. They're having to relocate the public parking to the public.
Did this have something to do with the new parking lot being moved and stuff like this?
No, and actually the commuter lot, we talked with MoDOT with the low number that they're looking at. Actually, the current parking lot that we have here, kind of where we put the electric charging stations, that's going to be used as a commuter lot. From staff's point of view, we've worked with MoDOT on that. So the idea being that that's what's going to help development on that northwest corner. Because it has to be moved, that's what frees up a little bit. think they, if I remember right, they asked for, I think, 30. So basically, you look at that road there, and then even going further to the, they use the one that's both side of the community center. There's parking spaces that basically never get used during the day. What we looked at was even like worst case, the full of the parking lot that constantly used, there's worst case spots. And to be honest, there's fewer people using now that you look at the community lot, but it's way down in terms of efficiency compared to what it used to be.
Additional questions? Seeing none, all in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, same sign.
6-0.
Next item, city attorney's report.
Nothing to report, Your Honor, thank you.
Next item, city administrator and staff report.
I think Shane and Davey have something.
Just real quick, Mayor, before Aldermen, something on Saturday, you know, the weekend, holiday weekend, our flights and season, there are state government this Saturday,
the only other thing we have was just a reminder about the annual citywide cleanup event that we'll have at our maintenance facility on June 4th. It'll be 8-2. I actually have flyers on the back table for anybody that wants to take it. We're doing a senior curbside pickup again if they call by May 27th. Get that set up to do the pickups on the 2nd and the 3rd.
Just say that on this flyer.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And if it's not already, it should be going up on Facebook. You know, last year it was a huge success. So I was going to have it after the garage sale for the unfortunate folks so you can get rid of their stuff. But that is all we have.
Okay. Next up then is Board of Aldermen reports and comments. Alderman Palachuk.
Just a question, and I don't know if it's starting, is it becomes going down and going down?
They will be, yeah, and I don't know off the top of my head the exact locations.
It was in state. I mean, moving forward, everything on, you guys have taken requests. I think we have a lot more requests than we can.
We definitely do.
Yeah. I just didn't know if there were any same locations from last time we did.
No. We kind of try to keep them at the same general area, not like on the same street every time. You know, if there was one in Valley Hill, we'd try to have one in that area again. They won't be on the same spot. So we got them in the same spot every time, but that's less good if people know about them and just circumvent them. They have the phone number again, but they can do perfect 6 or 7.
Does that include the one takes away from purchase? Don't we have some that takes away from purchase?
No one actually went
to have that. Yeah.
I know Valley Hills was going back and forth on it, but I don't believe that they actually purchased it.
I think probably about that too, especially when you did have school, and you have a lot more people just buying now, probably 6 9 bar. And I will say, I did see some good credit coming
Is there any street that there's the one that's dressed with, that we can do anything?
Yes, and I'll talk about that, with my time, when I get those out there, it should be pretty quick here.
Okay, Alderman Arnold? Alderman Dudley? Alderman West? Alderman Dobson?
I got a question on the river crossing down here in May, on May. Is that gonna be, is that gonna meet marine standards?
Yeah, so, and that's actually gonna be a little better than, we're hoping it's gonna be even better than the first design, when we reach out to the railroad again. You know, I don't know, probably a month or so ago, there was a piece that was stuck up, basically metal that was, had popped up. And when we called the railroad about that, Rick, the city engineer, well, he was one of their engineers, that basically was looking at it and saying, well, I don't understand why we're not, we can do more, to the crossing to basically bring it up, because all they did was replace the ties. A lot of the other stuff is still old, so they're actually looking to see if they got funds, that they can use to, when we go through and do our part of the project, basically they come through and make, their part of it as well. But, yeah, to answer your question a little better, on the south side, that elevation's actually coming up quite a bit, so it's not gonna be the.
Do you know what the rate standards are?
Yeah, it's like only a matter of, a couple inches for.
Three inches and 30 feet from the track. Elevation, 3 inches.
Because we, after you brought that up at a meeting, a few meetings ago, they brought that up to MoDOT, and they checked with the engineer and railroad, and everybody seemed to think that it was gonna be that standard. But I know it is gonna come up quite a bit on that south side.
I see it do something about that, and then, I mean, the cross is rebuilt, 10 years ago,
I'm gonna say, it seems like a problem when they, you know, did the whole strip, and you know, it's here, but pull up the old ties, put the new ones in.
Well, they used to pull them out and replace, now they have a machine that comes along, just pulls them out, just lays rock over top of about 4 to 6 inches each time, and just increases the level 6 inches each time. And what we've got there on the ending, by the fact that the speed off the door, yeah. That's not the way it's supposed to be. It's supposed to be in stands at 3 inches, 30 feet, and that's more like a foot at 6 inches.
You mean that the railroad's responsibility to do that then, or?
I mean, ultimately, they're responsible for it, if something was to happen, you know. And then the big concern is like a low-boy trailer going over it.
Yeah, the railroad always tries to blame it on the city, because the city's responsibility to maintain the intersection.
Right, and part of this, when you do a project that involves the railroad tracks, they have to sign off on the design for it. So, in theory, with this, they accept it as it is. Does that make sense?
Alderman Stanley?
No.
Okay, next up, there's a report. I have nothing personal to add this evening. Do I have a need for an executive session? Unless anyone else has anything for a regular session? Well, good.